Now look at this sun. Let's say this is the heart, which is the pump of the body. Okay. So I'm making the heart in a box form.
Yes.
So that we can understand it well. So once more, if it comes well, this is my heart. Okay. On top here are my lungs. And let's say these are all the parts of the body.
Yes.
Now, the body uses up, ठीक है, the oxygenated blood producing deoxygenated blood, which is carried by the veins. And this deoxygenated blood is poured into the heart. ठीक है. Now, the heart pumps the deoxygenated blood through the pulmonary artery into the lungs. In the lungs, the blood gets oxygenated and it is pushed back into the heart. The heart then pushes the blood to all the parts of the body so that it can be used by them. So, we have our heart right here in the middle, which is acting like a pump. The lungs, where the exchange of gases are taking place, and the body parts where the oxygenated blood is being used to perform different functions and deoxygenated blood is formed. So, is this clear? This simple flow is clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, let's look at it in a little bit in a more detailed manner. Let's say this is the heart. Okay? The heart is divided into four chambers. The right hand side will be the left atrium and the left ventricle.
Yes.
And the left hand side will be the right atrium and the right ventricle. Okay. The biggest vein of the body is known as the vena cava, which brings in the deoxygenated blood to the right atrium. When the right atrium contracts, it pushes the blood into the right ventricle. When the ventricles contract, it pushes the blood into the pulmonary artery.
Yes.
The artery is going to take the blood all the way into the lungs. In the lungs, the blood will get oxygenated. In the lungs, the blood is going to get
oxygenated.
And the oxygenated blood is brought back to the heart by pulmonary vein. The pulmonary vein is pouring the blood into the left atrium. The atrium contracts, pushes the blood into the left ventricle.
Yes, sir.
The ventricle contracts, pushes the blood into the aorta.
Aorta, yes.
Aorta takes the blood to different parts of the body where it divides into small arteries.
Yes.
The arteries further divide into small things known as capillaries.
Yes.
Capillaries are in direct contact with the body parts where the oxygen is taken in and carbon dioxide is released.
Yes.
Now this carbon dioxide is taken up by the veins. The small vena cava part is known as what? The veins. The veins combine back and pour, take the blood to the vena cava, which takes the blood back to the heart. Now, yes. This, my dear son, is known as double circulation. It is known as which circulation?
double circulation.
Why is it known as double circulation? Because one circulation is through the lungs, through the body part. Heart though is already there. So this is known as the pulmonary circulation, and body parts wala is known as the systemic circulation.
Yes.
Okay. So once more, let's look at our what is happening. Anything that brings the blood towards the heart, anything that brings the blood towards the heart is known as a vein. And anything that takes the blood away from the heart is known as an artery. Arteries generally carry oxygenated blood. Oh, what happened to this? Okay. So arteries generally carry which blood?
Oxygenated.
Except which one? Except which artery?
Sir, the pulmonary.
Yes. Except the pulmonary artery. Okay. Now, all the veins carry deoxygenated blood. All the veins carry what?
The deoxygenated
blood. Okay. And except which vein carries oxygenated blood?
The pulmonary.
The pulmonary. Okay. Yeah. Now, this part is totally clear to us. What is happening in the heart?
Yes.
Okay. So this is our better circulatory system of our body. In short, how does circulation of blood take place in our body? So is it clear to you?
Yes, sir.
So in the next class, you'll have to be prepared with the nutrition and the transportation part of it.
Okay.
Okay, then. Let's call it a day. Bye-bye. Good night.
Yes.